your number one priority if you were sworn in as a member of Congress?
My number one priority when I'm elected to Congress will be to do two things. I have two things I want to accomplish right away. One is to insist on term limits. I think until we change, the folks will be sitting there, until we change how long they can stay there, we're never going to change our government. Term limits is a must. It wasn't until President FDR decided to do 12 years that we put term limits on the president. Now we have congressmen like John Conyers, who was elected in 1964 and was booted out of office in 2017 because of a sexual misconduct. It's time that we get serious about restoring power to you and I. And my second priority really ties into my first priority, is doing something about what we talked about in the first question, the Administrative Procedures Act. Now, I know that's a little top here, but until we get that under control, we're not going to have a government. Our founders fought pretty hard to establish this Constitution to make sure that we had a judicial branch, a legislative branch, and an executive branch. And right now, because of Congress' failed leadership, their weakness, we have an administrative branch of government that controls every single aspect of our lives. And it takes someone who has leadership and the knowledge and courage to bring that back. And that's me. Thank you.
Thank you, Obit. So when it comes to the first thing I would do as a congressman legislatively, it would be to put in a bill to take away the perks, take away the fancy health care, take away the fancy pensions, take away the first class travel, to make Congress live like we all do, like everyday ordinary people. It's time for us to send someone to Washington, D.C. with that proven ability, which I have, to stand up against the establishment, to rein our government back in the fight for everyday people. But legislation aside, I think there's something that's actually more important, something that's missing today. Because ladies and gentlemen, you're not being represented by people in D.C. today. Our four people, representatives down in Washington, extreme, hard left, one type of agenda kind of people, and they don't listen to us. They don't help us, they're not there for us. The one biggest thing I've learned as a state senator, and where I spend most of my time, which is different than most other elected officials, is on constituent service. Because that's the job, ladies and gentlemen. It's about being there for you. It's about when you get sideways with your government, when you need help, because they're not helping your child that has special needs, or you're trying to get a visa and can't get it, or your business is being unduly penalized or restricted. You need someone that's going to stand with you. You need someone that's strong enough and bold enough with a proven ability on day number one, which I have, to be there for the people. That's what's most important. Thank you very much.
Yeah, what's most important for me having cancer is the fact that we have to, it's going to be some sort of health care to help with cancer and all those scenarios. But until the Wayfair decision came out, the Wayfair decision is going to pressure our companies, small business in particular. We have to rescind that. What that does to most companies is you have to employ somebody on staff to deal with all the tax issues that there are out there for each individual state. So what you have to do is you have to collect that tax, and hopefully when you pay that tax, it'll be paid in the right way and not have penalties. So the Wayfair decision has to be rescinded. That would be the first thing I would do. But I will say something else. I think people in Congress need term limits. Not only that, I will let you know, if I am elected as a congressperson, I will not take a salary. I will donate it to New Hampshire charity. Thank you.
Crop TV.